Hey guys, welcome to another commentary done by Diggity. Upper right corner we have Fischei starting as the mustard yellow Protoss. Bottom right corner we have DoLife starting as the teal Terran. This is going to be on Butter, and this is the first match between the two, part of BSL Season 15, Hasuleague, the last grouping of the round of eight. Should be a good one. DoLife going pretty deep previous seasons. Fischei is actually my current favorite to win it out of the remaining, and it looks like he's going to get creative early because sending out one of his initial probes to get in DoLife's face, maybe go for some proxy tech somewhere out in the map. We'll see momentarily. Now the question is does DoLife scout it? Secondarily, does he go for an in-base seal? And tertiary, which I just like saying as a word, so I gotta sneak it out there. How long is it gonna take him? Or how delayed is that the factory tech going to be as a result of all of these shenanigans? Oftentimes you'll see Protoss players actually just open one gate proxy, although usually not this close. Gonna put it right in front of DoLife's base. Is this SCV gonna head out? No, it looks like this is gonna be a front door seal, however. Supply depot being built near that egg. Depending on the timing of this, so this is going to be critical for Fischei. He blocks down the one gateway, so it does not look like he's going to go for two gateways. So this is more of an economic harass. Protoss can oftentimes recover from this. It looks like the barracks was sealed before the probe was able to get there and create any sort of disruption. So the zealots are going to have to hang out on this side of the wall. SCV actually leaving the barracks in construction, swapping them out, and doing a little harassment on the front. That probe taking significant damage. Is the SCV going to wander out and find the gateway, though? So gateway's going to finish actually well before the barracks. Refinery immediately down. But the Zealot is at best going to force some SCV repair here. He's not going to be able to press in to the Marines. It looks like we do have an assimilator up, but no gas mining as of yet for Fischei. So the barracks going to finish well behind the zealot. So the zealot's going to be right on front. Fortunately, also because of the placement of this barracks, Marines going to spawn in the bottom right hand corner rather than exterior. But this is a seal. No initial Marine. Factory before Marine as well. So that's not even going to be a slowdown of the initial factory. So the factory plopped down almost immediately. However, with that, SCV definitely need to pull off the line and hurry as the supply depot dropping in health. Only one SCV. I don't know if that's going to be sufficient because I do believe a single zealot and a single probe do sufficient damage. That probe actually being focus fired first because it has a bit of range here. SCV wandering and seeing the gas mining, seeing the cybernetic score planted down, also recognizes the proxy tech on location. Single SCV on gas, so DoLife is not feeling any pressure whatsoever here from this initial zealot and probe out on the front. Two Marines hanging out near the gap. Machine shop being dropped first rather than a vulture. Range being upgraded. A Dragoon is going to follow this up. So at best, what Fischei can do at this stage is potentially delay the natural expansion as long as possible. Three SCV back on gas. Four Marines slowly going to be out. Looks like an SCV is just pocketing to the corner. It can go out. Actually, I want to see if there's going to be a proxy engineering bay or supply depot, something to slow down that natural expansion. Suddenly can't talk. And force those units out. Dragoon out on the front. Does range those Marines from behind the bunker, but does not range the siege tank. An SCV is going to have to come off the line. And mines being researched from DoLife as a follow-up. So maybe going to go for some pressure. A very lackadaisical SCV making its way out here to keep that supply depot up and running. It looks like an SCV is waiting around the corner, potentially to blockade that front. But with that first siege tank out, yeah, the Dragoon is going to be forced back. We're going to see a second Dragoon? Yeah, second and third Dragoon are queued. Siege tech now being researched. So we got mines complete, siege tech being researched, still only one factory. So DoLife still thinking about going for just an economic grab at the natural expansion, but he's got to get through the two Dragoons and Zealots, so delaying this at the very least. But you can see DoLife also has this SCV in position. Is he going to track with the probe, though? Fischei potentially setting up to go ahead and grab his natural, so this is turning into more of like a economic detente Barracks lifted off. Siege tank splatting the probe, also splash damaging the Zealot. Fischei being forced out. Three Dragoons moving up. They're going to try to get as much damage on the Marine line as possible. Now working on that SCV cancellation of the bunker. Still these two siege tanks. Three siege tanks now should allow DoLife to go ahead and meander out and take his natural expansion. That is going to be behind the Nexus of Fischei though. But keep in mind, Fischei, he can just pull back with these Dragoons, which is really what he should do at this stage. He can try to defend this gateway. He can also maybe go see if he can sneak in and get a tank pickoff, which would be a little bit risky. I don't know that this bunker is even necessary, to be honest. Command center plopping down. Marines gathering up to go ahead and hop in. But now it kind of shifts into more of a standard economic game. SCV is going to be able to wander up and confirm the robotics facility. Dragoon range is finished, but there's plenty of siege tanks for DoLife to go ahead and defend. Dropping an engineering bay. Is going to want a couple turrets out, potentially, to deal with what might be an incoming robotics facility. Fischei paused production out of this gateway. So basically, he's effectively at what will soon be three-gate robotics. Just on extreme delays from both locations. DoLife pressing those Dragoons back as they're in smaller numbers to go ahead and take out this... Well, is he going to take out the gateway, or is he just going to press forward? I think he just wants to go ahead and wipe out this gateway. It looks like another Dragoon might get produced. But he can just move up with these five siege tanks in a bundle. Yeah, which it looks like is precisely what he's going to do. Natural expansion up for Fischei is not well saturated as of yet. Worker count, dead even. Second factory up. Mines look like... So I take it back. Mines canceled earlier. It looks like... That makes sense with the siege tank. I was kind of wondering about that. So mines now being upgraded. But I almost wonder if DoLife, looking at this, he knows there's a handful of Dragoons out here, but he's got a pretty sizable siege tank count. I'm wondering if he's going to try to play it economically aggressively and maybe even move to a quick third. Third gateway being tacked on. It looks like it's going to be observatory first. Fischei playing more passively. Does have a slight worker lead. DoLife now pressing forward. Losing a vulture from the high ground, but that's allowing tanks to kind of siege and bully a lot of these units back. Fischei slow playing this. A probe pocketed in that upper left-hand corner, maybe to grab a third. As DoLife pressing forward, being very aggressive with this. Vultures moving out, although they do not have that speed upgrade. But DoLife taking the territory he can get. Vulture sneaking through it. Should be able to intercept that probe in the upper left-hand corner. There is a decent pylon wall with Dragoons at the natural expansion to prevent that Vulture from sneaking and getting damage done there. In the meantime, Citadel of Adun, an additional gateway being tacked on, so DoLife pressing forward mid-map does have a degree, it looks like the Vulture actually able to sneak through and plant some mines that might cut off reinforcements for a brief time. That observatory is not that far away though. But DoLife being very, very aggressive with his unit positioning here. And the mine does land and take out four Dragoons before the observer's in place. And that is disastrous for Fischei. Now I don't think he has sufficient numbers, potentially, to keep DoLife with reinforcements from pushing him into his natural expansion, which would be a game-ending maneuver. So DoLife continuing to press forward. More Dragoons being wiped out, and DoLife, with very early pressure aggression, now has three siege tanks outside the natural expansion and mines along the way. There is an observer there, but this is not a great position for Fischei. Starting to produce more Dragoons, but they've got to go through a self-imposed gap and eating a lot of damage over that edge. The Vulture getting taken out by a probe. Nice probe kill there. More Vultures sneaking up to plant some mines and also potentially take out probes. Fischei in the red, as he's in a desperation mode, needs to defend his natural expansion. Another Dragoon getting just absolutely flattened for nothing. So DoLife looking in a strong position. Mines by the Nexus. He needs to be very, very careful. Some Zealots moving out. Is he going to have Zealot leg speed? Zealot leg speed will be finished in not too long. Let's see if DoLife, however, can reinforce with some more siege tanks. It looks like he's going to try to make the maneuver. Is able to pick off one siege tank on the corner. That leaves two remaining. More vulture reinforcements moving forward. The Dragoons still getting wiped out. A shuttle up to support, but there's nothing in it. And the Dragoons continuing to get obliterated by mines. Fischei calls GG. DoLife, through some very steady aggression in the early game, taking game one. Convincingly so. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And that's a rough start for Fischei. Thanks for listening.